Hey, Mom, can I tell you a question? Hey, Mom, what are you doing? Hey, Mom, do you want to see my new dance move? Hey, Mom, can you give me a snack? Hey, Mom, the dog peed on the floor. Mom, my sister won't stop touching me, and the dog won't get off my bed. My head hurts. I'm tired. Come lay down with me and read to me and sing to me. No, I said read to me. Mom, I just want to touch you. Mom, I think I'm having a panic attack. Because you need me for everything, and you never seem to want to ask your dad. Don't get me wrong. It's very validating to be the whole world to you, but I haven't showered now in over a week because you need me, but I need a break, and I'm living on coffee and leftover nuggets on your half-empty plate, and your expectations are just too much. I'm sorry, but there's a reason mommy's cringing away at your touch, because it just doesn't stop. And I'm never enough between the cooking and the working and the mess on the floor. I've sang this lullaby 6 times and you're still asking me for more because you want to play a game. But I just clocked out of work and all these things that I'm failing to do are making me rethink my worth. Like all my love can't cover your needs. Can't even take a break without someone commenting on how you're being raised by the TV, and I'm living under all of this pressure to be nicer and better and stronger and prettier and humbler and faster and smarter. And if you need anything, it should be like a rabbit out of a hat. All of your wants and needs should just fall right out of my ass. So I'm folding the laundry and doing the dishes and nursing the baby while I'm feeding the chickens and I'm paying the bills and shopping for clothes and trying to get ahead. But I think you and I both know that, baby, I am just too exhausted to fight you tonight. And I don't want to wrestle you into bed, so I'll give in just this once, even though that's what I said last night and the night before. Go ahead and grab your pillow before I change my mind and shut this door. Yes, you can come and sleep with me tonight. Yes, I love you more than anything. Even though you make me feel like I'm losing my mind, yes, I will snuggle you and pat your head and pet your hair. Even though you're coughing all over me like I can afford to catch whatever you have, I'll lay down with you tonight and wake up to do it again. Each day unfolding with frantic pace from dawn till dusk, like I'm falling behind in a losing race for a single reward of the love on your beautiful, sleeping, unconscious face. I want to tell you the story about the day you were born, about how I begged for you and prayed for you and dreamed of you for years, how I manifested you with nothing but the power of my own body, how the entire world, how time itself stood still while I cried for you and waited for you and labored for you. And all the books I read on meditation and birthing from within had scattered to the wind when the pain came. Wave after wave, drowning me from the inside out. They don't tell you that during labor, death and birth have a tendency to look like the same thing. But I was baptized in the waters of you and me, face no longer shrouded in tight-lipped uncertainty, but open, fearful vulnerability, more aware than I've ever been of my own mortality. I didn't realize how much I was afraid of before I had you. Before you, there was nothing I could think of that I could ever be this afraid to lose. You were everything. You were my mountain from the moment you rose from the deep volcano in your lungs, shifting and moving and quaking the earth like it'll never be the same again. We were born together, you and I, an island found and lost in the tide. All my joy and all my pride. They say that Earth, the mother, never forgets. That the ripples that grow into tsunamis are her reminder to us that every action leaves in the atmosphere behind it a question that must one day receive an answer, a reflection. There once was a woman who birthed a jaguar, whimpered wet nose in the air, searching a dirt-dug nest for his mother's milk. Our ancestors once believed that the spiritual sentience of the jaguar was such that it could travel through the in-between of this plane and another, hunting otherworldly jungles, tracking trails and pathways, and it was here that she was lost. But she is not the subject of our story. There was once a woman who stumbled upon a jaguar, a basket-reeded baby, nothing else in the world and no one around to ask. And she took that baby. She walked roads and trails, journeyed through mountains, swam great bodies of water, baby wrapped around her back just to bring him home again. Her breast bore comfort, but no food. And so she learned to bottle feed, learned to forage and work and steal to reflect for every need. She built him fire. When her single worn wool wouldn't keep out the cold, she called him son. When days and weeks and months passed and no other mother could be found, she ignored shamans who promised that they knew the answer. Follow and they will light the way. Give the jaguar to them, for only they could find the place where he could properly be brought to raise. And still, she walks, memorizing routes and corridors. We could still go here, but I think we've already been there before. In fact, I'm sure. Footsteps certain as an abacus, heart heavy as a mountain, and back broken stronger every day. The woman who carried the jaguar. No car, no cage, no support. Just two good hands and the wisdom of faith. She walked lines, tightrope thin and razor sharp, every day still believing deep in her weather-battered heart that there is a mother somewhere out here. She'll find her in her tree-shielded temple, hidden somewhere beneath, searching and waiting to catch his scent in the breeze. She calls him son. Although too sacrilegious to believe herself worthy of being called the mother, she could never. But the jaguar, paws on her shoulder, feet wrapped around her hips, knows that there is no one out there to find, because the earth and the jaguar never forget. And this is mother. This is mother.